talking about rooms, yes, rooms in your house, and also we are going to do listening exercise today, okay? Listening exercise about homes. Okay, this is our activity for today. I'm going to share the window right now. Okay, right now here. Can you see the window? Good morning. Can you see the window now?
Okay.
Yes. All right. Entonces, como les decía, chicos, el día de hoy vamos a hacer actividades de listening. ¿Ya? Yo voy a leer dos historias de dos jovencitos. Okay. And you are going to hear and write about them, yes? Van a escribir acerca de ellos. So, rooms of the house. First of all, I'm going to start asking you, yes, asking a question. How many, yes, do you know how many, quantity? Yes, for example, how many rooms, how many bedrooms do you have in your house? How many bedrooms? You know bedroom. Bedroom is a place. It's a place when you sleep, no? When you go to sleep and you have in your bedroom your bed, your closet, your pictures on the wall or posters. Okay, let's describe your bedroom. Okay, do you know bedroom? Yes, I'm talking about bedroom. Where is the bedroom here? Here is the bedroom, yes? So bedroom, it's a place. Yes, it's a place. Sorry. Yeah, this is your bedroom. Yeah, this is your bedroom. So you have in your bedroom, which things do you have in your bedroom? So you have your drawer, it's here. Yes, your bed, a bed. You have your closet. Yes, and some pictures on the wall. So this is your bedroom. So do you have a big house? A ver, ¿alguien puede participar? Do you have big or small house?
Living room.
Big or small house?
Big.
Me too. Yes. I've got a very big house. Yes. Because I have a lot of sisters and brothers. Yes. In total, we are 10 and with me 11. Yes, I've got five brothers and four sisters. So we are very, very big. So this is, I'm describing my parents' house. Yes, I'm describing my parents' house. For example, in the first floor, there is two living rooms. Two bathrooms, how many bedrooms? One, two, three bedrooms, and a kitchen, and a garage. And in the second floor, there are seven bedrooms. Seven bedrooms, a hall, yes, and a yeah. Big hall. So, my parents' rooms is very, very, very big. Chicos, ¿me entendieron? Estaba describiendo
sí,
la casa.
Sí, es bien grande su casa.
Sí, la sí. Casa de mis papás estaba describiendo. Es muy grande porque nosotros también somos una familia muy grande. Tengo 10 hermanos, conmigo 11. 5 hermanos varones y 4 hermanas. Hermanas. ¿Ya? So, the first floor and the second floor. And you, Adriana, do you have a big or a small house?
Big, miss.
Big also. How many bedrooms do you have in total? ¿Cuántas habitaciones hay en casa?
Four bedrooms. No.
Four bedrooms.
Son dos pisos, son dos pisos.
Yes, first floor. Primer piso se dice first floor.
Yeah,
second floor. And the third floor, tercer piso. In the first floor, how many rooms do you have in total? Rooms. You know rooms is in total, no? Habitaciones. So a living room, so a bedroom. Here is a bathroom. Por aquí está el bathroom.
Yes. Two bedrooms.
A garage. Aquí está el kitchen.
Kitchen.
Dining room.
Bathroom.
And a living room. Okay? How do you say yes? So, that's right. Yes, very good. María Fernanda, ¿por qué?
Sí, porque hay niñitos en la clase.
Está muy temprano. Es que luego me toca con tercer grado de primaria, pero tienen otro horario. María Fernanda, desconéctense, por favor. Ahora no voy a aceptar, sorry. Sin ver aceptado a María Fernanda. ¿Ok? María Fernanda, desconéctese, estamos en la clase de secundaria. ¿Ya? Yeah, goodbye. Entonces allí tenemos ya el bedroom, ¿no? The bedroom, que es su dormitorio, ¿ok? Your bathroom, ¿ok? Can you describe the things that you have in your bathroom? A ver, ¿qué cosas hay en el bathroom? ¿Ya? Yeah, for example, here is a bath, una bañera, a bath. And in the bath, you can take your shower, ¿no? En este caso solo hay una bañera, pero nosotros tenemos un shower, que es una ducha. Yes. And here, a shower. Yes. A shower, a toilet. Yes, a toilet. Nuestro servicio higiénico. Yes. A washing hand. A mirror. It's very important also to have a mirror in your bathroom. Yes, it's important to have a mirror in your bathroom to wash your face. Yes, to brush your hair. Yes, and also your items. You know, your personal items. Your personal care items. ¿Recuerdan que hicimos? Personal care items.
Sí, mi cepillo.
Yes. Your toothpaste. Your toothbrush. You remember in English? Toothbrush. Your toothpaste. Your soap. Your shampoo. All right? Those things are in the bathroom. So in the kitchen. In your kitchen, what things do you have in your kitchen? In your kitchen, chicos, ¿qué cosas hay en su cocina? What things do you have in your kitchen? Your kitchen. So there is a, ahí podemos utilizar para describir there is, okay? Hay, there is and there are. So there is a fridge, you know fridge? You can say fridge or refrigerator, right? Fridge or refrigerator, right? Más cortito, fridge. Fridge, right? And also you have a cooker.
Kitchen.
Pueden decirle cooker or stove. Yes? Stove, like yes. La cocina, ¿ya? Stove or cooker. Yes, cooker. ¿Cómo se dice? Cooker or stove. Stove. All right. And also, well, you have a cupboard. Catboard. Catboard vendría a ser esto. Esto como una mesada, algo así. Catboard. Yes, catboard. And also a catboard is when you put your glasses, your cap, your dishes, your spoons, your knife. You know knife? Knife is el cuchillo. Knife. Yes, spoon, la cuchara. Yes, spoon. So things in the kitchen. Yeah, spoon, knife, dishes. Yeah, los platos, different things here in the kitchen. In your dining room. Dining room. So dining room here, dining room. It's a place when you sit with your family to eat your, when you sit and eat your breakfast, your lunch, and your
dinner.
Mm-hmm. You sit to eat with your family, the three meals, yes, the three meals a day, no? The three meals a day. Donde te sientas pues a comer las tres comidas del día, no? Yes, your breakfast, your lunch, and your dinner. And which things do you have in your dining room?
Table.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The table, Anna. And the chairs. Mm-hmm. That's right. Tables, chairs. Yeah, table, chairs. Excellent. And what about the living room? So what about your living room? Your living room.
Como la sala. El lugar para estar, Miss.
That's right. Yes, it's a place when you sit and watch TV. You do different distractions there, no? Different distractions. You can sit on the sofa. Yes, on the sofa and watch TV. You can sit on your living room and talk. Yes. And talk to your family and talk together, talk to your friends. You can do different activities in your living room, yes? In your living room. You can make parties in your living room, yes? Make parties, but not now, no? Not now. So later you can do parties in your living room. Allí se hace la pachanga, la fiesta, no? In the living room. En la sala donde se recibe. Living room. All right. So please, now. Now, please, the first activity. Yes, you have to match and write. Yes, and write. Write each room, yes, depend of the description. For example, number one, read a book. In which place do you read a book? It's done, yes? El ejercicio número uno is match the action with the rooms of the house. Follow the example. For example, number one is done, yeah? La número uno ya está hecho. Number one is done. So, read a book. So, you can do in the
bedroom.
Mm-hmm. Number two. Where do you eat lunch? Lunch.
Dining room.
In the
dining room.
Dining room. That's right. Write them, please. In the dining room. Yes. Dining room. Dining room. Este lugar. Dining room. Okay. This is the pronunciation. In the dining room. Number three. In which place do you wash a car?
Garage.
Garage. That's right. In the garage. In the garage. In the garage. In the garage.
¿Y para qué Vallejos, Joshua? No, no es de aquí, ¿verdad?
Sorry. All right. Number four. In which place you make breakfast?
In the dining kitchen.
In the kitchen, that's right. Number five. In which place do you take a shower?
In the bathroom.
The bathroom.
Yes, bathroom, all right. And number six, in which place do you watch TV?
In the living room.
Excellent. In the living room. Yes, in the living room. So now I'm going to read about two teenagers. Okay, voy a leer, chicos. Les voy a leer acerca de dos jóvenes. Okay, para eso tengo este mapa de aquí. Yes, I have here a map. Yes, I'm going to tell you first of all where they are. Where they are from. Yes, en dónde se encuentran, de dónde son. Where they are from. Yes, did you hear about Yemen? Where is Yemen? Where exactly is Yemen? And the Democratic Republic of Congo? Do you know where are those places? ¿De dónde son esos lugares, chicos? Here I have a map from. Can you tell me about this map, this continent? So which country is in Africa? Yemen or Democratic Republic of the Congo?
La B, creo.
Yeah, so those places, Yemen, it's a country. Yes, it's a small country. And Congo also, it's a country. So those places are here. Look at here. Yes, those places are here. So Yemen and Democratic Republic of Congo are from Africa. Yes, los dos países, chicos, son de África. Yes, are from Africa. So which country is from Asia, Yemen or Democratic? So ninguno, yeah, ninguno, chicos, porque los dos, look at the, miren el mapa, es el continente africano. So the two places, yeah, the two countries are from Africa, ya, yeah? Los dos lugares son de África. So, estos chicos que voy a leer a continuación son de estos dos lugares, all right? From Yemen and from Africa. So, listen to me, me van a escuchar, yes, to read about those students, yes, voy a leer acerca de estos dos estudiantes, yes, and listen to the teacher and level the room, ok, me van a escuchar describir la casa de cada uno de ellos y luego me van a escribir aquí debajito, tienen en cada casa, 1, 2, 3, 4, qué habitaciones están describiendo en cada casa, alright, yeah, listen to me. Me van a escuchar. Listen to the teacher. Yes, to describe. So, Muna is the girl. Yes, Muna is this girl. Listen to Muna. Listen to Muna. Yes, me van a escuchar. Yeah, listen to Muna. And you are going to write here in exercise one. Yes, done. In level number two. Number three and number four, yes? Me van a completar allí qué habitaciones estoy describiendo. So listen to Muna. Good morning, everyone. I am Muna Sayed from Yemen. Yes, I am 8 years old. We are under lockdown here and schools are closed. It's very important to stay at home to prevent the spread of COVID-19, yeah? Today, I want to show you my home. My dad likes watching TV in the living room every afternoon. Sometimes I do my homework here in the morning. We eat lunch together in the dining room. My sister Rema and I sleep in one bedroom. She reads books here every afternoon and I do my homework here every morning. I love my bedroom. My sister and I dance here every night. My mom cooks breakfast, lunch, and dinner in the kitchen every day. My sister and I help my mom regularly. I love my family and my home. Yes, but I miss my school friends. Sometimes we speak on the phone. And now, please, listen to the boy. Yes, Cornell. Cornell. Listen to Cornell's house. Cornell is the boy's name. Good morning, everyone. My name's Cornell from Democratic Republic of Congo. Yeah? And I am 20 years old. We are under lockdown here and schools are closed. It's important to stay home also to prevent the COVID, yeah? Today, I'm going to show you my home. My dad makes breakfast in the kitchen every morning and my mom cooks lunch and dinner. And every day, sometimes, my brother and I help my mom in the kitchen. My bathroom is big. My dad takes a shower here every morning and the rest of us take a shower every afternoon. I like my bedroom. My brother and I share the bedroom. Hashus reads a book in the bedroom every afternoon. Sometimes I do my homework here in the evening. My brother and I wash my family's car in the garage every Saturday. I love my family and my home, and I miss the school. My friends and I chat on the phone every day. Yeah, so I read about Muna and Cornell's house. So can you tell me, please, the rooms of Muna's house? ¿Anotaron, chicos?
Sí, creo que segundo estaba su sala. En yeah. Tercero estaba su
number
cuarto.
Number two, living room. And this is my... Anotaron
ahí era dining room.
Living room, because yeah, he's her dad watching TV. Yes, in the living room. Beth, where do you sleep?
Bedroom.
In the bedroom. Yes, my sister Rema and I sleep in one bedroom. Estaba describiendo de su bedroom. Them. Three. My mom cooks. Where they? Where?
Kitchen.
Yes, in the kitchen. In the kitchen. A four. And four. Watching TV. Yes, in the dining room. Sleeping in the bedroom. And afternoon, the bedroom. My homework in the bedroom. Yes, my mom cooks in them. And number four. I'm sorry. ¿De qué habitación más habló?
Bedroom.
In the bathroom. No, dining room. It's okay. Dining yes, room. Dining room.
Eso me estaba diciendo,
sorry. Sorry, sorry. Yeah. Now, talking about Cornell's house. Cornell's house. ¿Qué habitaciones describió Cornell de su casa? One.
Bedroom.
Yeah, bedroom.
Bathroom.
Kid, yes. Bathroom.
Garage.
And la primera habitación que escribió fue, listen, my dad makes breakfast in the, my dad makes kitchen, breakfast kitchen. In the kitchen. Yes, the first room was kitchen. La primera habitación fue la cocina. Yes, the first room, yes, he described was his kitchen. The second was, his dad takes a shower in the bathroom. My dad takes a shower in the bathroom every morning before to go to his work. Yes. Entonces, number one, it was kitchen. Number two was bathroom. Yes. Number three.
Yo sé que la cuatro es garage.
Garage. No, Yes, number four is garage. That's right. Number four is garage. And number three, talking about share. ¿Con quién comparte su
bedroom?
His bedroom. Él comparte su habitación con su hermano, ¿no? He shared his bedroom with his brother, ¿yeah? With his brother. That's right. Excellent. And here, and next exercise. In the next exercise, here, yes, talking about also the listening, you are going to write, chicos, aquí me van a escribir los nombres, ¿ya? You're going to write the names of Muna, yes, Muna or Cornel. Cornel is the name of the boy, yeah? For example, likes watching TV every afternoon. ¿A quién le gustaba ver la televisión? Cada tarde, likes watching TV every afternoon.
Muna.
Muna's dad, Muna. ¿No? Uh-huh. Ahí está, Muna's dad. Yes, Muna's dad. And where? ¿En qué lugar? Where? ¿Dónde? In the
living room.
In the living room. Cooks lunch every afternoon. Cooks lunch every afternoon. A ver, voy a mencionarlo nuevamente. Who? Muna, yes, Muna. That's right. Muna, where? ¿En qué lugar?
Kitchen.
Kitchen, yes. Dances every night. Dances every Muna. Night. Muna.
Sí, ella baila, ¿no?
Yes. Where? ¿En qué lugar?
Living room.
In his living room, yes. Does work in the evening.
El niñito, me dice el papá del niñito.
Yes. Who is it? Cornel. Yes, Cornel. Where? ¿En qué lugar?
En el bathroom.
Does homework? Hace su tarea in his bedroom, ¿ya? Yeah? In his bedroom.
¿No se dijo que se baña?
No, homework. That's homework.
Ahí estaba, la 4.
No, en la 3, en la 3. Sorry. That's homework in the evening. Mm-hmm. Cornel in his bedroom. 4. Takes a shower every morning.
Cornel's dad.
Cornel's dad?
The Muna's dad.
Cornel's dad, creo, porque decía que se bañaba en la mañana.
Es su papá.
Yeah. A ver, dice, I want to take my dad makes breakfast. No, my dad makes breakfast. So it's Muna's. Today I want to show my every, dice, a ver, in the dining room, the kitchen. Yeah, that's right. It's Cornel, yeah? Mm-hmm. It's Cornel's dad
in the bathroom.
In the bathroom. Excellent, very good. You're good in comprehension. Yes, comprehension. So this is for you, students, to your homework. Yeah, this is for you to your homework. So please rewrite, que vuelvas a escribir, rewrite, yes, correct the following sentences about routines, yes, number one of the example. For example, chicos, ¿dónde se ubica estos adverbios de frecuencia? Every day se ubica, pueden ubicarlo al inicio o al final de la oración, ya, no puede estar en el medio, al inicio o al final, every, cada. Yes, every day, cada día, every morning, cada mañana, yes, every evening, cada tarde, every afternoon, cada tarde, ¿no? Every evening, sorry, every evening, cada noche, every evening. Ok, me las ubican, ya, me las ordenan, esas oraciones. Yes, about routine, and here in the next exercise, yeah, in the next exercise, in the next exercise here, you are going to circle, yes, to ABC, según, yes, según la rutina que hagas, ok, por la mañana, por la tarde, por la noche. Y en number four, please create some sentences. Create some sentences like this example. Like this example. Yeah, I take a shower in the bathroom every evening. Yes, I take a shower in the bathroom every evening. A ver, ¿qué oración puedo hacer aquí con eat with my family? Comer con mi familia. ¿Dónde? ¿En qué lugar?
In the kitchen.
In the kitchen. Entonces, la número uno puede ser así. I, primera persona, ¿no? Yo como con mi familia. Entonces, ¿cómo sería la oración? I eat with my family in the kitchen. Y puedo poner ahí un adverbio de frecuencia. Every, utilizando every, ¿ya? Aquí muy bien dice, utilizando every, ¿ya? Every. Bueno, ahí me ponen en que se juntan la familia. ¿En qué horario se juntan la familia? Si es por la mañana, por la tarde o por la noche, ¿ya? Entonces, I eat with my family in the evening, puede ser por las noches, in the afternoon, por las tardes, in the morning, all right? Así siguen el ejemplo, ¿ok? Read a book. ¿En dónde lees un libro? ¿Ya? Entonces la número dos será, ¿en qué lugar lees un libro? I read a book in the, pues en your bedroom, in the living room, ¿ya? Puedes leer en tu sala, en tu... De esa manera. Luego utilizas every. ¿Yes? Every. Every. Cada, every significa cada, ¿ya? Entonces ahí me pone every morning, afternoon, una rutina, ¿en qué lugar? Igual watch TV y allí me creas otra oración. All right, chicos, allí termina ya la sesión del día de hoy, ¿ok? El número, a ver, con watch TV... Para ayudarlos, ¿cómo puede ser su oración con Watch TV?
I watch TV in the living room every night.
Excellent. Every night. That's right. A ver, chicos, los demás, ¿están entendiendo? Maylin, Arlette, Ximena, la verdad es que no sé si están allí.
Sí, sí entiendo.
Abel, René.
Acá estoy, profesor.
¿Ahí están?
Sí, me estoy.
Muy bien. Sí. Ay, me alegro escucharlo, su voz. Sus voices. Your voices. Ok. Entonces, allí tenemos tres. Number four. Otra oración que puedan hacer ustedes. Otra rutina. ¿Qué ya hemos venido haciendo? ¿Otra rutina, chicos? Take a shower. ¿Dónde se duchan? Ay. O brush my teeth. ¿Dónde se cepillan? Brush también hemos hecho. ¿Recuerdan? Brush. Brush teeth. Cepillarse. Hemos hecho wash hands. Lavarse las manos. Ay. Puedo poner mi... Me lavo las manos, ¿no? I wash my hands in the bathroom.
Yes. Every morning.
Every day, todos los días. Every day. Me ponen every day, todos los días. ¿Ya? I wash my hands, so I brush my teeth in the bathroom every day, ¿ok? Al final, chicos. Every day me lo ponen al final, ¿ok? Every day. ¿Otra oración que pueden hacer? ¿Otra rutina? ¿Otra rutina? ¿Número 5?
I cook a dinner in the kitchen every night.
Excellent. I cook the dinner. Yes, I cook the dinner in the kitchen every night. Excellent, students. Yeah, like this. Chicos, eso sería la clase del día de hoy. Ya les estoy enviando el video para que puedan repasar la lección. All right? Thank you. Goodbye, students. Bye-bye.
Teachers, ya nos vemos.
Goodbye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Take it, please.
Chao.